Now, are you back in touch with someone you've not spoken to in ages? Maybe rekindling an old friendship? It's thought that during the social restrictions, many of us are doing this. There's a BBC article with several stories of ex-partners getting in touch to apologise years after the relationship. So is lockdown a good time to reach out? Well, let's talk about this with Veronica Hannon. She knows a thing or two about getting in touch. She founded Transform Communications in Bradford and Avon. Hi, Veronica.
Hello, good morning. How are you?
Yeah, really well, and lovely to have you with us. Do you think now is a good time to get back in touch with someone you've not spoken to in ages?
Do you know, I do, because we, for the first time in what seems like absolutely ages, it feels like we have time. Suddenly our diaries aren't quite as busy as they were, definitely the social diaries, and we are having a little bit more time to pause and reflect, remember, and rethink, and think about, you know, people that we used to know, used to love, that maybe have fallen by the wayside or drifted away from us. So yes, I absolutely do think it is a really good time to rekindle those connections and friendships.
Although in some ways it's already quite a stressful and emotional time. It's risky, isn't it? You know, reaching out to someone who's not been in your life for so long.
Well, I think that there might be the personal risk that people feel about, you know, the potential for rejection that could come, potential for, you know, the fact that you might just not have different things in common. And also, you don't know what other people are going through at this time. So I would always say it's, from a communications perspective, it's really useful to understand why you want to connect with them. What is the cause? And this sort of links through to some of that apology pieces that appeared on the BBC. You know, if we really want to apologise to somebody for our past behaviour, why is now a good time? What are we trying to fulfil in ourselves?
I mean, it's a minefield, but what is the best way to do that, to apologise to someone for something which happened years ago? I mean, how would you do that carefully and sensitively?
It does need to be really carefully and sensitively done. And I think it absolutely starts with, why do you feel the need to apologize? Is it because of guilt? Is it because you are seeking their forgiveness and redemption? Is it because you feel as if maybe something has passed you by, and that if you treated it differently, there might have been a different outcome to it? So really understanding what it is you want from the other person, because if it is something that you need, then that's not always the best way to approach it. Because, you know, you're asking for something. Somebody else's life might have moved on. You know, they might be totally happy. They might have forgotten about you totally. That might be a good thing. Yeah. So it needs to be really sensitively done. But understanding what you need from them is a really good starting point. And hopefully there is nothing. There's just the need to say, you know, I'd really like to get back in touch, or I'm really sorry for how I behaved.
Okay, interesting. Thank you so much for that. It's really good to hear from you today, Veronica. Veronica Hannon there, founder of Transform Communications. They are in Bradford and Avon.